The one and only Paul Pickett, host of the Paul Pickett Podcast, aka Triple P, aka the Premises Podcast, on sports music, sports politics, and much more. Today I'm going to react to a video from the Coffee Pot. Woman complains not enough attractive men. I can already know where this is about to go. But before we do that, I want to give you a word from one of our sponsors. As you see, that's a video with Dizzle and Langer. So Dizzle should have something coming soon with Langer Juice, hopefully. And check it out. You see, we got a bunch of new things coming for the new year. Bunch of new Dizzle recipes and whatnot. You want to order your very own bottle or bottles of Dizzle Premium Luxury Liqueur, go to DizzleBrand.com. Click on Our Locations. Must be 21 and over. Shipping and handling is included. Also, it's locations in California, Oklahoma, Kansas, and Arkansas, plus the Dizzle Brand hats, t-shirts. Go to DizzleBrand.com, click on merchandise store, or go to Etsy.com/shop/DizzleBrand, Etsy.com/shop/DizzleBrand. Just so you know, Dizzle is a premium luxury liqueur mixed with agave, tequila, French cognac, and orange liquor mango mix. Throw your Dizzle on ice, and it's nice. You don't got to mix it with Coke, like Henny and Coke and all these other things. That gotta go. Gin and juice, you know, Dizzle, as good as it is, just throw it on ice. All right, here we go to Coffee Pod, even though I don't drink coffee. Let's see what he got to say.
What's up, YouTube? Welcome to the Coffee Pod. My name is Chishi Zed.
Drink the coffee, it'll make you feel better.
Woman says that she's pissed off because the ratio of attractive women to attractive men is completely imbalanced. So guys, what I'm gonna play you here is actually a back and forth between two TikTokers. And it starts off with the woman who claims, listen, it's so hard to find an attractive man. And then a man—
Before he finishes, I guarantee they're not gonna take into account that there's a lot of unattractive women wearing it. Shit ton of makeup to look attractive. They're not gonna go off of natural looks and natural beauty. I guarantee that. Let's keep it moving.
And responded to what she had to say. Got pretty heated, comments were crazy, and as you would expect, we're about to get into all of that. No more wasting time. Let's get it.
You know what pisses me off so bad?
Talk to me.
Is that the ratio of attractive women to attractive men is off. Like, if I wanted to go find an attractive woman on Instagram right now, I could do it in 2 seconds. If I wanted to go find an attractive man on Instagram, I have to put on my CIA cap, my FBI badge to find that dude, to find any man. Cause they don't make pages. Dudes don't even post for real. What's the issue?
All right, there you go, guys. You just saw the video for yourself. So the chick basically just said, hey, it's hard to find an attractive man out here. A man that looks good. If I'm looking for a woman, all I have to do, she says, is open the Instagram.
She ain't looking at me.
And practically, probably like the first woman she sees will be beautiful. But here's where the story gets interesting. We have a guy who actually responded back to this chick, and it got pretty heated. The conversation and back and forth went viral. But before we do that, let's check out these comments underneath her first video and let's see what the people had to say about what she said. So the first comment here says, she thinks she one of them, with the question mark and the laughing emojis. Okay, so obviously first commenter is like, wait, you? So do you think you're one of these highly attractive women that you're talking about.
She
was, and we've got another comment here from another person who says, in 2022, it feels like we as men can't do anything right. LOL, 186 likes. Another person responded back to that comment and said, it's been like that for ages. What do you guys think, right? Do you think that in 2022, it feels like you can't do anything right as men? Next comment here from another.
And you know, before we finish, I'm a straight white heterosexual male, and you know, I'm the most evil person and villain on the planet. So yeah, I guess I can't do anything right.
Gentleman says, I think the makeup should be accounted for because yes, I am let down 75% of the time once it's taken off.
Like I said, but not count for natural beauty.
They won't like that coffee.
This coffee smells like shit.
No. They don't want
to. Yeah, like they don't take into account that, man, we just jump in the shower, comb our hair, throw on a hat, and throw on some deodorant, some cologne, and that's it. We're not, you know, plucking our eyebrows, putting on lipstick, eyeshadow, blush, doing our nails. You know, we're not doing all these extra excessive accessories to look better, you know. And that's the thing, like, makeup works wonders, but once you take it off, you ain't gonna be able to just work wonders with natural beauty all the time.
that's facts right there, man. And I think all men have been in a situation, some are currently in a situation, where they were misled, right, by makeup, the sorcery of the foundation, concealer. People can do some crazy things with makeup today.
So not that works, there's anything
wrong with it, but when taken to the extreme, it can be misleading. And it could also produce delusional women who think that they are tens when they are not. Next comment here from another man says, we don't use no enhancements. We're natural.
Thank you.
Find the last few comments here. First woman says, they're so mad in the comments, but it don't change the fact that it's easier to find an attractive female over a male on the internet. Another gentleman responded back to that woman and said, this means y'all aren't the prize, since attractive women can be found in abundance.
Wow. Man,
she wasn't ready for that. She's like, hold on.
Put that coffee down.
This guy's trying to make me think. Yeah, man, the beauty conversation when it comes to women is very strange. It's like, are there beautiful women or are they not? Women will be like, oh, we're all beautiful. Okay.
No.
So do some of you look better than others? In different types of ways. Okay, then you're all beautiful. Does makeup make you beautiful? No. You know, we just do it for ourselves. All right?
Yeah, sure. Lies.
Backwards, a bunch of lies. So guys, here's where things get really interesting. So we have a guy who actually responded back to that chick, and his response went viral. No more wasting time. Let's get it.
The ratio of attractive women to attractive men is off.
Take all the makeup off your face and post your face right after you get out the shower. That is how men have to walk around looking.
Drink the coffee, it'll make you.
Facts. I did it the other day. I literally posted a picture out of the shower. I didn't look as good as when I put on my hat and put on the shirt, because I'm a little, my chest is a little flabby. I do got somewhat of a computer gut, you know, and I haven't had a haircut like I should have, but it's cold right now, so I'm not in a rush to get a haircut and get my fade, because, you know, that coldness that hit my head. So, yeah, I didn't look all that great as soon as I got out. Once I put on my hat, I looked better. But that's, like you said, that's all we can do is just comb our hair or put on a hat. We can't, you know, we're not, unless you're, you know, transgender or gay or drag queen or something, you know what, we don't really have any intentions of putting on makeup, you know. And this idea that women, or we only put on makeup just for just to make us happy, no, because that was the case, you wouldn't need makeup if you were just, you know, happy being you. That's the thing. Anybody who's just comfortable in their own skin, they don't have to do all these extra things. You know, don't got to do all these extra things to make themselves feel better. They'll just feel better just for being themselves. Let's keep it moving.
I feel better.
Drink that coffee. This man's preaching right now.
Unfortunately, I only drink Coca-Cola.
I've made videos like this before, but I don't think y'all understand.
Talk about
that it. Most women, especially most attractive women, put on costumes before they leave the house. The hair in your head is not yours. If a man has bad skin, he just has to wear bad skin. He doesn't get to cover it up with a different color of foundation. Women,
thank you.
Heterosexual men, this is facts.
Like I just said,
this is true.
Toward their face to try and change the appearance of their bone structure. That is literally what makes you attractive or not. What your parents gave you, you camouflage that. Now change the color of your lips. Now wear waist shapers. Then slap three filters on after all of that and call yourself pretty. That
mercy.
Yeah, I didn't even. I forgot about the filters. Yeah,
take it easy, bro. They're not ready for
filters.
It.
Like, come on, man.
That's why you can go find so many beautiful women on the internet. There are just as many attractive men as there are attractive women. It's just that average women appear attractive.
Oof. Yeah, they weren't ready for that truth, bro. They weren't ready for that truth. So guys, we have a gentleman here who says, listen. You women can say that it's so hard to find attractive men because we're all tens, right? We're so beautiful. Now, nice. I don't know if that chick in the video believe she is a 10, but I wouldn't be surprised if she admitted that she is, because
six
most women
seven,
think
maybe.
They're all 10s. Here's what's interesting, right? Women will like try to dismiss that there is a rating system at all in general, but when it's time to use it, they all are like, oh, we're all 10s. I'm like, okay, well, are you the fact that you can claim you're a 10 means that there actually is a rating system, right? But that's besides the point. Let's get back into what my man was saying. He said, listen, you women can claim that you cannot find an attractive man that easily, but the truth is you alter your real appearance. And he's basically saying most of you are average, and you may not think that you're average. Why? Because you're altering your appearance with fake hair.
Basically, you know, I've heard enough. What he's saying is you're taking credit for something the makeup has done, and you're taking credit for something your camera phone has done with filters. You don't get to take credit for something else, that something else has done or someone else has done. You know, you don't get to take credit for things that you didn't do yourself. The makeup is what made you beautiful. The filters is what made you beautiful. You don't get to take credit and say, you know, I'm beautiful, and you're caked up with makeup and you're doing all these filters. Like, take that off and then let's say, are you beautiful? You know, like, people always be taking credit for things that they didn't do or not in their making whatsoever, you know. But thank you for tuning in, Paul Pickett Podcast, and I'm out.